Oh, hi. Okay, so now that that's done, now you gotta recalibrate and reposition all your needles. And then same thing what I did, I did is I turned the key on and I figured out which other two pins had power whenever they had the ignition. So it turns out to be the opposite pins on the bottom, and then the far right one, looking at the connector, is the negative. The one right next to it is the positive, the ignition source. So that's the way I have it hooked up right now, on the opposite side pins. And let me pause. I don't know how much you can hear my music, but when I put the power to it, you'll be able to hear the motors kind of reset. You hear that? So what you gotta do is set the needles in, kind of get them into position, hit the power, and it'll go down and reset it. And if it's not in position, you'll have to take the needle back off and reposition it and try again until you get them all zeroed out for when there's absolutely no power or for when the ignition comes on. So that's what I'm gonna do next. Look a little bit off, but it's depending on the angle of the camera because I'm so close. But they're all pretty much there. See, watch when I connect them, connect the power, they'll reset. So I think I like all of them except the fuel. I think the fuel is just a little bit too high. Everything else seems to be right on the money. So, probably gonna reset the fuel one. And that's it. Okay. So there it is. Light where that's. I like it to be a little bit under, because I never let it go under a quarter tank anyways, but there it is. So, that's done. Ready to put back in the truck, but now, I gotta do this thing. I gotta take that clear lens off and start getting it ready to paint. So that's gonna be it. That'll be tomorrow. It's kind of getting late. I'm gonna head inside, kick back, and we'll pick this back up tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Now that what I'm gonna do today, so I'm gonna take the lens off of this, so I can start painting it and prepping it. What I'm going to do is I use a razor blade, and pretty much all you got to do is go around the edge and just cut that like glue and seal that's in there. So I'll go ahead and start taking that off. Here's another look at the cluster, kind of in the daylight. I'm going to have to clean off some of the fingerprints before I put it back together. But I like it. Came up pretty good. And you want to be really careful to not touch the backside. You don't want to leave any fingerprints. I mean, you can, but you have to be careful. Make sure you clean it off really good before you glue it back together. Okay. So now that this is open, what I'm going to do is I'm going to be using Prep All for cleaning plastics. And then I'm going to hit it with some adhesion promoter. So what I'm doing in this step is I'm using red pinstripe tape to tape off the chrome part of my bezel. Be really precise when you're laying it down, because if you're too far into the black texture part, when you go to peel the tape off, you might end up peeling part of the paint with it. And obviously if you paint it too far back, if you don't tape it enough, you might end up getting overspray on your chrome part. So be really precise on this step. Okay, so here is the final product. Taped off. I couldn't find, what I recommend is using the blue fine line painter's tape that they use to lay down like really thin lines for automotive paint, but I couldn't find it at O'Reilly's, Advance, or AutoZone. So the next best thing is to use pinstripe and to use the single strip. You don't need to have that double one. But that's what I use to tape off, kind of give it that fine line around the edge. And then I just kind of masked off the big areas with the blue painter's tape, or you can use the green or yellow automotive tape. That'll probably work better for you. But it's all taped off, ready to go. I'm gonna first go over it with wax and grease remover, just to give it a little extra cleaning. After that, I'll hit it with the Prep All. It's like another cleaning for plastics. And then after that, we'll do the adhesion promoter. And then once we get through all those steps, is then we'll start laying some paint. And kind of want to lay down some white first. That way the red shows up a little bit better and it's not on a black background. So after I do the first three steps to prep it, I'll do the white as a base coat, and then my color coat will be the red, and then I'll go over with the clear coat. So I'll start cleaning it here, and then we'll get to painting. Here is, after three coats of white, and I did like a fog coat. So that's pretty much gonna be my base coat, so that red would show up a little bit better. And now I'm gonna hit it with the Toreador Red. I don't know how you pronounce that, but it's a fourth color, unfortunately. So the red is next. Okay, so now my layer of red is done. Now what I need to do is tape along the very edge, and then I want to paint this inside part black. And then once I paint that black, it'll be ready for the final clear coat. So let's tape that off. So far my second coat of black. I'm gonna do one more coat, and then I'll peel the tape off and I'll be ready for the clear coat. Can't wait. So I didn't get to film the last few coats of clear coat, but the sand clear coat really didn't come out that good. I got a lot of fogginess, like it almost like a flat. It really wasn't that shiny. So I used instead the duplicolor clear, and that came out a whole lot better. And it looks pretty sweet. Check it out.
Bitch.